it's not sufficient for me to love God alone if I do not love my neighbor. I belong to God and to the poor, says Saint Vincent de Paul, whose feast we celebrate today. He is the patron of all charitable institutions. Saint Vincent de Paul was born to a poor peasant family in the French village of Puy on April 24, 1581. His first formal education was sponsored by the Franciscans. He did so well that he was hired to tutor the children of a nearby wealthy family. Vincent de Paul spent the first 20 years of his life seeking fame and wealth because he wanted to escape his humble roots. His family also shared his ambition. Vincent de Paul became a priest at the age of 19, and he spent most of his early priesthood mingling with the members of the elite family. He was very well liked because of his charm, intelligence, and sense of humor. In 1605, Vincent was returning home from a trip by a boat, and he was captured by pirates who brought him to Tunis in northern Africa. He was sold into slavery, and he remained there for 2 years. During this time, he prayed to God, telling him that if he would be spared and if he was freed, he would devote the rest of his life in the service of the poor. 2 years later, he and his master managed to escape from there and they returned to France. After his eventual escape from Africa, Vincent served a church in rural France. The poverty he found there shocked him, and he began to seek financial assistance from his former wealthy and influential friends. He met with affluent friends and inspired them to organize into groups, going from house to house requesting furniture, food, and clothing. They were extremely successful in their efforts to help the people of that area. It's true that Saint Vincent de Paul was a legend of his own time. As time went by, Vincent realized the mistakes of his young life, especially his focus on wealth and fame. In 1617, two events transformed his life and gave him peace of soul. The deathbed confession of a dying man who had the fame of being a good man revealed to Vincent his sins he had never dared to reveal to other priests due to shame or self-love. This opened Vincent's eyes to the crying spiritual needs of the peasantry of France. In a second instant, Saint Vincent encountered face to face an agonizing person who experienced extreme moral loneliness, feeling the impossibility of talking to a gentle God. Here is where the heart of Saint Vincent's vocation was found. Gentleness. His heart was touched. He desired to go to the farthest places and to tell all those who find themselves lost that God exists, that He is a God of gentleness who has not forgotten them. Later, he founded an order of priests, the Congregation of Priests of the Mission, now known as Vincentians, who devote their lives to the spiritual and material needs of the poor. He was a pioneer in clerical training and was instrumental in establishing seminaries. He was zealous in conducting retreats for the clergy at a time when there was great laxity, abuse, and ignorance among them. Along with Louis de Marillac, he founded the Sisters of Charity. He then expanded his work, founding hospitals, orphanages, and homes for the people who are mentally ill. He also devoted his last years to the prisoners and slaves, sharing with them the the story of Hope as a former slave himself. He was very well known throughout Europe in his own time. He died on September 27, 1660, and he was canonized by Pope Clement XIII in 1737. He is recognized for his charity and reform of the clergy, as well as for his early role in opposing Jansenism. He is referred to as the Apostle of Charity and the Father of the Poor. The gentleness of God, which he was able to communicate to the people of all walks of life, especially of the sinful, sick, lonely, and the poor, remains as a challenge and inspiration for us to do our part in this earthly life as disciples of Jesus. Happy feast to all of you.